Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to MoreShay with Marshay. Today's video is going to be a 29-week pregnancy update, my journey thus far. I think I finally said that right. So, okay, 29 weeks pregnancy journey update thus far. I don't know what you can see from me sitting, as always. It's a little bit different from how I will actually look in person and the camera and the whole nine, but I don't know if y'all can kind of see that bump right there. Now y'all gonna see my mic cord, but whatever. So 29 weeks. For me, did not have a doctor's appointment this week. Had to get prenatal vitamins again this week, which was a bit difficult just because the pharmacy I'm used to going to did not have it at all. And the problem is I called them to make sure that they were gonna have my prescription. And then they told me a time. They said 11 a.m. I get there and it's like 5, 6 p.m. And they say, oh, it's not ready yet. We only have something else. Okay. Then I'm like, okay, how does that make sense? And they're like, well, we got the prescription, but we don't have prenatal vitamins. That's what they're saying now. So I'm like, why didn't they tell me that this morning? Is like really upsetting me because first of all, I just sat in that drive-through line, which takes forever. Probably almost nearly an hour, it felt like. And not only that, but I already was tired, had a long day, was driving all day, practically not all day. And when I say all day, I don't drive all day. That don't mean like early in the morning to late in the afternoon. I don't really drive that long. Probably 6 to 7 hours on average. But I just was tired. I was irritated. I had to get gas and food and all types of other things. And I was really upset because I'm like, why would they not have my prescription ready? So they said they're going to send it to the nearest pharmacy. Because I was like, just send it to the nearest one. I don't care which one. Sent it to another one. I went to go drive again today. And so I nearly was trying to call the other pharmacy to make sure they had my prescription. Practically half the day because in between me driving, I'm trying to call and then have to hang up because they're not answering fast enough or I can't communicate what I need to fast enough before a passenger is in the car. So that is definitely difficult. And there's this back and forth thing right now that's going on with me and my primary care or my physician's office because I'm trying to schedule my appointment for 30 weeks and they don't have space in the schedule and they're trying to call me to kind of make room. And it's just difficult. I don't really have the time to answer, or for some reason I don't answer, I miss the call. It's just a lot. But as far as everything else, I feel like pregnancy this week is still pretty easy, I would say. When I say easy, I mean there's nothing shocking or surprising. Only thing is when I sleep, I am a bit like uncomfortable. Laying down, period, I'm a bit uncomfortable. And I have a pregnancy pillow the whole nine, but I still feel uncomfortable. And when not laying down, not sleeping, I'm not gonna lie, when I drive for a long period of time, at times my lower calf or like near my ankle begins to feel like a slight pain. Nothing serious. Just feels like maybe I need to stretch, get up and elevate my leg a bit. Probably tired of just being in the position that it was in for so long. But aside from that, I don't feel like there's been anything really, really crazy happening at 29 weeks for me. I'm trying to think. Yeah, nothing really, really crazy. I would just say heartburn. Oh, that has definitely increased. I don't know about everybody, but for me, my heartburn has definitely increased. Like at night, the heartburn is the worst. I just feel this burn, this ache, and it just blows me. Like I really don't like that. But aside from the heartburn, maybe some uncomfortability laying down at night. I pee a lot, which I think it's practically normal, but I pee a lot before being pregnant. So, of course, I'm going to pee while pregnant. So that to a certain extent can be uncomfortable, but I'm so used to going to the bathroom anyway. It's just what I do. those two, three things. Anything else? No, I don't really feel like there's anything else. I know that I do have a 30-week appointment coming up. I've had a couple of meetings this week with someone, a part of my team who will be a part of the postpartum part of my team, who I'll begin to speak with more after I have the baby. She was just calling to introduce herself, which was really, really cool. Aside from that, I had a meeting with my my birth support worker. As always, we kind of went over my birth plan a bit, not the full out birth plan, but we kind of more so talked about the birthing process and what labor actually looks like and what it can feel like and etc. And I'm going to be completely honest with you all, I was way less educated than I thought. And this is the thing that I loved about it, is when she asked me, she was like, okay, what do you know about the stages of labor, or do you know a lot about the birthing process and the stages of labor? And in my head, me being the type of person that think I know certain things, I wanted to say yes, because it's like I think I know about pregnancy and like birthing and labor and all of that. But then I said no, because I was like, you know what, there's probably so much that goes into it that I really don't know that's actually happening. And I don't, because I've never been a part of anyone else's process. I wanted to for the longest. Like, everybody that I knew was having a baby, I always in my head was like, I wish I could be at the hospital when they had the baby, or go or be with them. And anybody I was close to, I kind of really wanted to be there, because I want to see that process. I want to know what it's like. I've never ever ever experienced it. I've never seen it like in person, only through videos and Instagram posts and the whole nine, but never in person. So I really wanted to see it. I really wanted to know what it was like. And I felt like I didn't know much, because I'm like, I've never been a part of that process. I've never had kids myself, so I don't know. So I told her, like, no, I really don't know that much. So as she was going over things, I'm not going to lie, it began to bring up the terms, memories, things that I've heard and or known. So I did be like, okay, I recognize that, or I remember this. But it was great to learn, because there were so many stages and things that would happen that I didn't know, including like when you're in pre-labor. Like, I really didn't know that, you know, there was a process of time before going to the hospital. I thought immediately you feel contractions or your water break and you go to the hospital, or you try to get there as fast as you can. And of course, that sounds like some fairy tale movie stuff, but of course, because that's what the movies tell you. It's like, as soon as a person water break, or as soon as they having these intense contractions and they're afraid of what's going to happen next, they rush to the hospital and everybody's going crazy and just trying to get there. When in actuality, she's like, you can really take that time to enjoy yourself. Try to relax as much as you can, or pack the bag, or bounce on your ball, or do whatever it is that you need to do just to make yourself feel comfortable, talk, laugh, etc. And then when those contractions really get to a 411, I believe, and I don't remember what those numbers mean, I think it's four something, every something something, y'all might know what that means, but 411, I believe, is the numbers. Then that's the time when you want to head to the hospital, once those contractions are really, really getting started. She said, you'll be able to tell, others around you will be able to tell, because your mood will completely change, your attitude, everything. Like, you will know. Because I was like, is it any way that, you know, you really can be in labor and not know? Like, I don't know. Me, I'm thinking, like, you know, some people, ooh, this, the way I'm sitting, this looks so uncomfortable looking from over there on the camera. But I was like, I don't know, because I know people be having their babies at home or on the toilet and all types of things, and I'm like, did they not know, like, that they were in labor? But she said, when the contractions come, you'll pretty much know, especially when it gets to that point of, yes, we need to go to the hospital now. Okay, so, I mean, if you're like me, no, it's not like the movies. Please don't allow the movies to just educate you as far as like pregnancy and labor and delivery, and don't think that's the whole gist of it all, because it's not. I also was supposed to have another meeting with a person of my team this week, but was unable to. So I was supposed to have like three meetings, only was able to do two. First of all, the weather, it's been really hot and beautiful one day, then rainy and a mess like today. So that's been fluctuating throughout the week as well. But as far as anything else, I don't feel like there's anything really significant. I feel like my mood with me being pregnant, I don't know if this is my mood with me being pregnant, or I don't know if it's just things around me. So I don't really even want to say that 100%, because it could be my mood, or it could be things around me that could be making me just feel that type of way. So I don't really want to say yet until I figure that out. But yeah, I think that's about it for this 29-week pregnancy update. I feel like I don't know what size the baby is supposed to be this week. I'll find out for you guys next week and let you all know. If I did not tell you already, my glucose and anemia test came back and everything was perfectly normal, which is wonderful, which is great. The whole team really, like, you know, okay, good, great. You know, everything came back great as far as that, which is really, really good, because I expect it to be like different pregnant. I expected, you know, health concerns, health issues, and all of these different things, and to not have that so far for 29 weeks has really, 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 really amazed me. And I don't want to go into this god thing, scares some people because some people don't like hearing about God. But I don't care what people like to hear. I'm gonna be honest about what I think and what I feel. I was talking to God when I got in the shower, or before I got in the shower, the bath, whatever. I was talking to God. I was having a conversation, and I just had to thank God because I was like, out of all the things that be happening to me, people don't know like what really be happening around me or to me or in my life or etc., because I feel like the type of life I live, it makes it look so good. Like, and it's not me, because I don't sell no pretty pictures. I don't go out and make things look better than they are or whatever. And I'm not saying things are like, oh my God, the worst, like, no. But I'm just saying the way things look when it refers to me, people think I am whoever I am. I don't know why they think that. I don't know if it's the way I carry myself, who I am, whatever. I don't know what it is, because I don't try to do anything. I'm just me. But I feel like because of the way people may think I am, or the way things may look, or it may seem, or it may feel for other people, they don't know that a lot of the times there's a lot going on, a lot of minor details that happen in my life that are not always the best, small things that just come and throw its way my way. And you be just looking like, well, why? And I be looking and I be thinking all the time, like, why me? What I do? And I be like, dang, like, I don't even do nothing. I always think that. But then I be like, you know what I did do? It's like, nah. But no, like, I don't really do that much. So I'm like, why the little minor things like to throw itself my way and like to always mix up and mangle and evolve itself in my life and cause a little riffraff, you know, not to keep everything just floating? Well, of course everything isn't going to flow, but it's like they say too, the devil is not going to come mess with no house where he know there's nothing at. So of course I expect, you know, some trouble. But when some trouble be turning into more trouble and all this trouble and a lot of things just don't be right, and I be like, why? Like, what is going on? Like, I work hard. I get up every day with a mindset of I'm focused. Like, I love God. Like, I just don't be understanding. I move with a pure heart. I don't be out here trying to sneak and snide and all that stuff that people do. I don't understand it. And I speak on it so much in, like, almost every video, because I don't like when people are sneaky or manipulative or masterminders. Like, I'm nothing like that. I really live with the genuine, this is who I am, and this is what I like, and this is what I do. And I don't be trying to affect other people's atmospheres. Like, if that's not how they live, cool, you know? So, normally things be trying to throw its way my way, and it's always some trouble or anything regarding me. I always feel like it has to be a little worse than it should be, you know, compared to what I feel should happen, right? But when it came to this pregnancy, I don't know if I should say this early or should I wait, because I was telling myself to wait, but for some reason I just want to say it. Like, when it came to this pregnancy and God just making everything work out for me so perfectly, so smoothly, so easily, I just get so grateful. People don't know how I act. Like, when I'm alone, I'm really praying, I'm really crying, I'm really talking to God, because I'm like, I can't believe, like, I'm mind blown that so far in my pregnancy I haven't had any issues. So far in my pregnancy I haven't had anything, you know, like, scare me. Like, I'm always expecting or thinking that something is going to come and it's going to be bad, or it's not going to be good, or it's not going to go well. And when things are going well like that, it scares me. So for my pregnancy to just be like as beautiful as I feel it has been, like, really this baby is being good to me, you know. Like, a lot of people say they can't even tell I'm pregnant on this camera. I look pretty pregnant, sloppy, but I don't really look that sloppy in person, okay? I just feel like, you know, I feel like, dang, I'm like, thank you, God. I said this to God. I'm like, the one thing God decided to work out for me, because he knew I would have wanted this more than anything else to work, was me carrying my child and doing it well. I feel like God knows just how much I love children, just how much I love my own child, and how much I want to be the best that I can be, that he's making sure everything is working out for me smoothly and perfectly. And if nothing else in my life was going right, I feel like God made sure this was the one thing that is actually going well. Like, everything else can be a mess. I really don't care about that, because it's always some mess. But God is like, one thing I'm not going to do is have her suffer in this moment. One thing I'm not going to do is have anything negative come her way whenever it comes to regard, you know, of this child, because God knows how I feel, like, about kids, or my own especially. So with the pregnancy part, I'm just like, oh my gosh, like, it's nothing like, this ain't coming up, this ain't coming. Like, I be expecting something. And when it's going so smooth like that, I'm like, thank you, God. Thank you, God. Like, really. So pay attention. You know, God shows up when he does. And in every other aspect of life, I'm not gonna act like life is just, oh my gosh. But I just feel like it'd be certain things that I expected of myself, wanted for myself, wanted, expected. And then I'm just like, what? Why my life not lining up like I feel like it's supposed to? But even with the pregnancy, it's a surprise. But God is like, I'm gonna make sure one thing go right. And that's you and that's child. And I'm just like, I kept on saying when I was in the shower, I'm like, my womb is blessed. And I know this because it's no way, like, this baby is making it so easy for me. Like, it's little things, but that stuff is nothing. Like, he's making it so easy for me. And I'm just saying that to say I'm grateful. That's it. Okay? That's all I wanted to say. I'm grateful for that one thing going well. If nothing else goes well, I don't care. I'd say it all the time. I just want it to be me and this baby against the world. Like, and not saying against the world. I hate when I say that too, because I don't want it to be like against the world. But I just want it to be us. You know, that's how I feel. I just want it to be us, Lord. Can it just be us? Can we just do well? Can we just be okay? Can we be more than okay? Can we be happy? And so far, he's doing well. God is doing a good job. Okay? But, that was just my little spill. So y'all be grateful for whatever it is. Pay attention. God gonna show up somewhere, whether it's your kids, they're gonna be just so beautiful or blessed to you or so amazing, so great. Everything else may be a mess, but that one little baby come up and give you a hug, all of a sudden you're smiling and your life feels much better. It was a reason. So no, it's a reason. You know, because I would have thought, why would I need to get pregnant at 25 and have a baby at 26? That just don't feel like me. Like, why? That just don't fit my ideal lifestyle, the thoughts that I thought I had for me. But then God is like, yeah, I do. And I'm just going to have to sit back, watch, and see. That's how I feel, you know? It ain't about your plan. It's about his plan, okay? So I'll talk to you guys later. As always, this is MoreShay with Marshay. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram at MoreShayH, at MoreShay with Marshay, and at Misfit Inc. And I'll talk to you guys soon.